Yeah, anymore? Cannot think of anything. Too busy listening. Huh? Yes, no, no, yes.
Seems no more questions, Master.
No more? You are sleeping, huh? Only me working, huh? Not fair, not fair. Okay, never mind. I'm glad to see you, and I'm glad that you're working for this noble work. Even more noble, because you will not see how many people benefit from it. You probably understand that it will benefit the world, but you have not yourself seen it. Sometimes you hear it from Hotline or other disciples told you, but you yourself don't know how much benefit your work is giving the world. So even then, you just have faith and do it.
Yes,
and believe in that. And this is very, very unconditional, very selfless. Because most people, when they do something, they want the satisfaction of knowing the result. You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
So they feel successful, feel happy. We don't even have this. We don't even have this luxury. But now and then we heard it from the Hotline or from other disciples. Well, at least you have faith, and that's very good of you. Okay? I want to thank you, all of you, and the people outside.
Thank you, Master.
Yes. Bravo. Thank you, thank you. Yes, I'm glad that your faith is so strong, and your selfless heart is also very strong, so that even though you don't see the result, you don't have the luxury of experiencing the outcome of your noble work, but you still continue doing it, believing that goodness will bring goodness, you know? And your work, because of goodness, it will bring goodness to the world. To be able to believe that, you must have a very good heart, a very noble intention inside you, even though you might be too humble to recognize that. And it's okay too. It's okay too, because if we know too much, who knows, maybe our ego will pop up, then it might be making trouble for our daily concentration in our work, okay?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
But believe me, your work is very powerful. You are helping the whole world, and not just the world, but the heavens, lower heavens, and the hell as well. And all the animals are thanking you. And the hell people are thanking you. Heavens are thanking you. Even though you, not all of you might see it. But it's all right. We don't have to be happy. We don't have to know the result of our work. But we understand that it is good because we are doing good. Right?
Yes.
Our work must bear some goodness, must bear some good fruit, because it's good work that we're doing. The best work that we're doing, even if we don't see, we don't hear, we know, we believe that it's good. Our work brings goodness to the world. And if you do believe it, it brings good to heaven as well, and to hell. And of course to the animals, obviously. More and more people become vegan because of Supreme Master Television. Of course, it's because of many other saints and sages and good people who are working outside there, okay? Outside of our circle. Like the vegan people, the vegan promoter people, the animal rescue people, the government who approve vegan or approve the end of animal cruelty, etc., etc. All of them are also working very hard and helping the planet. So it cannot be bad. It can only be good and better and better. Okay? Yeah.
Yes.
And for your unshaken faith, I congratulate you and I'm very proud of you. And thank you, of course. Thank you.
Thank you, Master.
Thank you for being our inspiration, Master. You inspire us every day.
For sure, I'm Superwoman. If, If you see my table, my desk, full of wires, all different color, different kinds, then you know for sure I'm Superwoman. Because I don't know if any ordinary woman can live, sleep, and meditate or function in this kind of environment. Except for you guys. You are, I say, machine geek, yeah? Computer geek. You love computer. You love anything machine. Yeah, I'm a woman. I don't love it. I'm a poet, actually, at heart.
Yes, Master, you are.
Yeah, I love to make songs, I love to write poetry, I love to take photographs of beautiful things. I'm softer than a man, and now I have to be tough. Do all these kind of things. To you, maybe it's nothing, but for me, it's really a big, big job to connect all these wires.
It's a lot, Master, it's a lot.
Even it's a lot for you?
It's a lot for you, Master.
It is for me.
It's too much.
I confess, I'm not saying I'm that tough that this is a piece of cake. No, it's not. I can't believe I did all this, connecting this and that and others together and making it function. Yeah, I could even talk to you. I wanted this long ago, yeah, but I thought it's not possible for a computer zero like me, yeah? Because although a superwoman like me, I don't know if tomorrow or next day we will have a chance to talk to each other. Okay, huh? Yes. Who knows? We take one day at a time. Whenever we can, we count it as a very, very miraculous blessing. Yeah? Okay?
Yes.
Yeah. All right. Okay. If you don't have any more questions, then I will tell you about another story. You want that?
Yes.
Thank you, Master.
Okay, you want to hear about Satan or you want to hear about Moses and the ants?
Moses and the ants.
Moses, good. We just talked about him, right? So we continue this way. Yes. This is the first book. And the stories in this book are simple and easy to listen to, easy to digest. So that's why I started with it. You know, in the second and third book, be more sophisticated, deeper spiritually. Okay? I just remember vaguely like that. I can't remember all the stories in there. Okay, so now Moses and the ants. Originally, I didn't choose it. I didn't choose this one. I thought it's too short and it's not much. But by the way, I saw it today. When Moses was on Mount Sinai and was blessed with the initiation and the Ten Commandments, I wonder if this was really God himself personally, or it was the master who transmitted to him all this initiation. You see that what we read is like initiation, yeah? The commandments and the silent the remembrance of God, but not to speak loudly about God's name, yeah?
Yes.
Or in any occasion at random, he is forbidden. So it's like maybe there was a saintly master who gave him this initiation on the Mount Sinai. Most masters, they like to live on a mountain, you know, far away from the dust of the world. So maybe there was a physical master that gave him initiation and these Ten Commandments. And then God came down and told them. Concerning the bush with the fire, maybe the master sat under the tree, surrounded by the cooling bushes, yeah, and trees and plants. And the fire is the light from the master that emits from his being or her being. You understand now?
Yes, Master.
And then normally, like in India, the people look upon the master as God personified. Just like many of your brother and sister also address me thus. Remember? Yeah?
Yes,
because they think the master represents God, and sometimes they call him or her God-man, or God-woman, yes, or Holy Mother from God, something like that. So I guess that Moses was on the Mount Sinai having the master's initiation. Yeah, and of course he could see God through the initiation, through the light and the sound of God, of the music and light of heavens. So now he was there on Mount Sinai, and then God gave him the 10th commandments. Afterward, now Moses told the Israel's descendants about God's 10 commandments, but they did not keep it. They did not believe Moses had seen God and the 10 commandments. And so they became idolatrous also, yes. They made not even just a statue of any past saint even, or any heaven or angels even. They made the statues of golden calf?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, yeah. And they worship that. Because one of Moses' brother or relatives, family member, told them that, I have a golden calf. You should believe in this. It's easier. What for you believe Moses when he said about God you don't even see? I have the golden calf. You can see. So you should worship the calf. So everybody listened to that person. Who was that? Was Moses' brother or cousin or? I forgot. Anyway, you can see wherever there is a positive pole, there's a negative that spring up, yeah? Just like in Jesus' life or Buddha's life. It was Judas or there were other opposing him or the Buddha's cousin, yeah?
Yes.
Okay, now they even worshipped the golden calf instead of God. So God punished them with a big plague. And 30,000 people died from that pandemic. Oh, 30,000 is a lot for that time, yeah? Yes. Because yes. There was only a small group of people who follow Moses out of Egypt. Remember?
Yes.
They were in Egypt and they were slaves working for the Pharaoh of Egypt at that time to build this and that and others. And they were treated like slaves. Yeah, they were even forbidden to openly worship God in their own religion. They went out of Egypt, and it's not like a big group. So 30,000 people died from the pandemic. That is a very big, big number for them. You understand? You can imagine, right? Okay. It's not just that they worshipped the golden calf. They also sinned against the Ten Commandments. You see, because God said, don't kill. Don't steal and all that. But they probably did all that because they ate meat. And instead of eating the vegan diet that God has told Moses to do, that is sinning more together with the worshipping of the, you know, the statue of the calf. That is the sinning. Very, very sinful. The eating of the meat. That's why in the Bible it says meat for the belly and belly for the meat, and God shall destroy both meat and them. It's like one time they asked God to give them, they say, you gave our ancestor manna, cannot you give meat as well? So God rained down meat for them to eat, and God destroyed them all. You see that?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
So it's a precept, it's a commandment that they also sin against, against God's will, against God's rules. Not just the worshiping of the calf only, because they went the wrong way. They don't worship God. They don't keep God's commandments. They just worship the calf, and then they think the calf will help them, bless them, so they could do anything they wanted. And they sinned further down, you know, eating meat and killing and all that. That's why. That's why God punished them by the plague, by the pandemic.
Mm-hmm. 了解我们是